Onivia, League of Legends highlights.
Always good to see Perks on this champion, but it is one of the more immobile champions that can often
come out. It's got a song attached to it.
Yeah,
there,
it does.
Draco,
yeah.
So,
we'll leave it at that.
Yeah,
you know,
we'll leave it
don't
at
go
that.
Into
actually,
the details.
So good. Now neither of us want this.
Bottom side crab should be traded with top side. Doin B and FPX very well know bottom side controlled there by Blabber, by Cloud9. So you can see this positioning is what you need to do as mid laner. They shouldn't over chase because
it's going to be the setup though. Waterblade there as well. Easy follow up. Tien just saw them coming and stayed focused on the crab. Blabber, can he move in and snipe this one away? Blabber, full commit, goes over the.
Oh! Dracos! They can't lose! Blabber got both.
Four dive at 6 minutes is still a highly risky proposition. Good news. Doon B in the mid lane, no mana whatsoever. He's instantly going to pop a biscuit. That's going to be clutch as it gives him just enough time to instantly turn it off. Point and click. He did not cancel it, and he will get his kill.
Beautiful there from Doon B.
The early support roam matched 4v4 on top side. Ezreal ultimate can come from Cloud9 as well. Definitely shouldn't underestimate the damage that that can add for a river fight.
They're just trying to burst down the Camille though. Instantly going to dodge though. The follow-up CC is there. Ken and all trying to get something back. But Fudge is still living for now. They do manage to take him down. Tien just a sliver of health. Vulcan now going in once again. Now the other roll from downtown will not connect onto Tien, but Nagari will drop. Crisp now running for the hills. Do they have any more C? The lockdown should be there. Rakan not going to be able to jump back out to safety. Cloud9 getting the kills. Herald still getting taken down. That is good for the side of Cloud9. Really hoping for more than just two plates off the back of that one. That said, Vulcan's going to be in hot. Oh.
Yeah, he was able to dodge it.
Turning around, is going to go in, is going to go for the stun to interrupt. Perk's still getting lower, has to be careful, has to respect potential burst damage, but he's just walking in, he's playing on the edge of match, he's playing on the edge, Zombie already going down. Tien, he has to wait for his cooldowns to come back up, he gets another flag and drag, maybe Perks will drop, but he will not. Fudge now coming in, FPX stick around a little too long. Vulcan hiding out in the bush, gets so much for the team, but now Sven trying to survive. Tower aggro tanked by Crisp, but Blabber on the way in. I see two juicy low health targets, an Iron Spike Whip, and a very hungry Qiyana. Step forward. Flash out. I didn't see the flash. Yeah. I had to adjust. I didn't see the flash was up.
He's got the one escape plus the other one escape. That's looking good.
That's two with Sesame Street, baby. We're counting. Nuri going in, but it looks like he might just get dropped. Fudge still holding on. Going back under the enemy tower. Nuri holding on. Instantly going to see the staring contest here on the top side. Fudge, though, winning out for now. Doon B gets the reset on the Malefic Visions, but Blabber's in the area. It's an absolute bloodbath. It's an absolute mess, but it's Cloud9 who are coming out on top. Empowered Root into the Blabber double kill. Herald can immediately be dropped on the top side.
The map control results. In a lot of extra gold, and Jarvan's starting up this dragon. Ocean Drake does slow you. It's one of the more annoying ones to go for, and there is Vulcan.
Going in, attempting the steal, but now the TPs are coming in. Tien running out to safety. The Fudge on the chase. It's the tax sweep. Finds the kill. Cloud9, this is very, very good, Kobe. This is very, very good.
Definitely plays in right into their gameplay. I'm trying to
Cloud9 ahead for the vast majority of this game. That said, LWX certainly getting the better of bottom side as he has been left on an island for so long. He's catching a wave on the bottom side.
Yeah, this is definitely good for Fudge to try and catch up further into this game. Meanwhile, Rift Herald number two on the map, and FPX, since they fully committed everybody up to the top side defense, can look flank around
Sven. Caught out. Sven immediately going to be locked up. That's the charm into the knock. He's going to try to go over the wall, but Tien already flashing a little bit early. Sven trying to stick it out, knowing that he's dead anyway. Nuggery going to grab one in the meantime on the top side, just like those. But FPX felt like they were starting to fall behind, but really good heads up play, really good flank coming in from Tien. And the tier two tower.
Oh man, those things are so juicy now, too. They're not losing extra territory here. Getting basically a 2-for-1 on objective. Have a high priority on those. Dragon going to be given over in exchange. So in the end,
not bad. Absolutely. The question is, are they willing to commit Nuggery's TP to send him back to the top side of the map to defend this push? Or are they going to fully commit to this bottom push? They've got Shelly charging in. That's the tier 2 tower. Looks like they're not going to push for anything else. Now we see, of course, the dragon going down. Only the second dragon of the game here from the side of FPX, as you highlighted earlier.
Okay, we'll just collect. And that's why it's stalled out a bit, is both sides have been just collecting.
Trading farm of Perks. Now going to get all engaged on. Is going to use the QSS, but it might not be enough. Perfect coming in for Chris. Predicts it. Is going to connect him with the edge of the charm. Perks now running for the hills. He's very fast with the phase rush, but not fast enough. The Realm Orb comes out, but he will not escape. Massive shutdown going over to Nuggery. Can they make something bigger out of it?
Great. That makes the setup on Baron that much easier. Can C9 stop them with four?
Blabber's ult is big. Ezreal's ult is big. Nagari now stepping forward. Kennen ult.
Early smite.
Now going into the pit. Big damage. Early smite has already come out. Fudge now in the area. The MF ult not going to really connect on too many people, but that is the Kennen ult into the midst of the entire team. Fudge is still living. Sven still living. FPX. They overstayed. They overfought. They thought they had a bad. side of Cloud9, and now it's the Baron they've got their eyes on.
It's still so dangerous.
They keep the members of FPX pinned inside the pit. Baron DPS was even helping them out the entire time. Huge, huge pickup inside one of those objectives. You're putting yourself in the death trap. And so, very well done there by Cloud9 to defend 4v5. But positioning advantage can sometimes mean so much more than even a full character. Here is Perks.
Locked up immediately, going to QSS, though. He does a lot of damage back. But Nagari just too strong. Already has the Void Staff, shreds through those resistances. Fudge needs to be
waved, as well as picking up Dragon number 3. And it really does a lot to take away some of the power of this Baron. This relieves so much pressure on FPX. So another critical pickoff there on Perks. First one you can kind of meme on. Okay, we need to mark this Kennen. It is going to be the job of Leona, the job of Fudge as well. Everybody's got their eyes peeled for the last positions of Kennen so that they can throw some of the CC at him. Because he doesn't have a Banshee's Veil, because he doesn't have any of these defensive options, it's their frontline's job to mark him.
Blabber immediately going to get just deleted. Fudge can now go in. There's no more ult in the area. Vulcan now coming up as well. As they take down this Kennen, it should set them up nicely. Not for any major objectives, but at least shutting him down for a little bit here. Now you're going to get burned down there. One for one in the end.
Okay, so they marked him. Little bit close there on the inside. It still takes so much damage. Let's take a look at the attempt from Tien.
It's not an attempt. Okay. We're trading side lane picks here. He's going to go in a clean sidestep there. Means Perks is going to make it out to safety, but Crisp might still be chasing. The MF does have a ton of damage. No armor on the rise to speak of. He does manage to get the knock up, locks him in place, manages to get out, but still, Crisp, the predictions are clean. LWX comes in.
He's even got teleport. He could get back quickly. They don't have setup. They don't have vision on the dragon, though, so Cloud9 at least avoid that. Yeah, C9 want to draw them into the river so you can get more value out of your Qiyana ultimate. Makes it so much easier to hit since you get...
Oh. Flash forward, Perks locked up and instantly taken down. That's going to stop it in its tracks, and Kennen doesn't even look like he needs a stopwatch right now. This should just be an uncontested Baron. The Ezreal ulti coming down, but it will not be the Miracle Steal. Now FPX are going to have control.
Ready for that one.
Doonby now stepping forward. The Siege coming in. This is the power of the Baron. Perks in the meantime sticking to the side lane. It's going to look to trade one inhibitor for one inhibitor, but FPX might just look to end the game.
Yep.
A lot of tools to get these fights kicked off. Keep in mind, LWX, we haven't really seen a big ultimate yet, but the MF is massive. Good damage forcing Blabber back. He's got no health left. They're instantly cutting through all of C9. Perks on a side lane. Not nearly fast enough to end the game, but now it's a race. The Ryze just does not have enough power. Blabber trying to buy as much time as he can. Sven trying to buy as much time as he can, but the base race is not there for C9. FPX will take the game.
And they make your heart beat a little faster, but FPX caught...